Now as we know how to connect the two half cells together, the value of volt or cell potential between them can be measured by multimeter, and it also can be calculated from the standard value, and we will see about this. The electromotive force of the cell, and we use the E cell like this, E, capital E subscript cell, to represent the electromotive force, and this can also be called as cell potential or cell voltage. This is the maximum potential difference between the electrodes of galvanic cell. The example that we've seen many times already, the cell voltage of Daniell cell, or the connection between zinc half cell and copper half cell, has the cell voltage equal to 1.103 volt. How do we get this value? The calculation of cell voltage is like this: E cell equal to E of cathode minus E of anode, where E here is the reduction potential of cathode and anode. E represent in this equation is the reduction potential of cathode and anode. And if we look at the system at standard state, the system at standard state, we use the superscript zero, so we can calculate E cell zero, that is equal to E of the cathode at standard state minus E of the anode at standard state. The standard state, or the standard electrode potential, is the electrode potential when the concentration of solute are 1 molar, the gas pressure are 1 atm, and normal temperature would be 25 degrees Celsius. And as I said, we use the superscript zero to signify the standard state condition. The value of standard reduction potentials can be found in most general chemistry textbooks. In this particular one that I show you, rank the reduction potential, highest value on top, lowest value below. Every reactions that show here are reduction, half reaction. Reduction means receive electron, right? So the receiving of electron on the reactant side of the reaction show the plus, some plus electrons. All right. Let's remind you a little bit about the terminology that is called a substance. A substance that receive electrons are called oxidizing agent. So oxidizing agent receive electron and produce reducing agent. As in this table, the highest value of reduction reaction is on top, which means that this is the strongest oxidizing agent. So the opposite direction, this one down here, lithium, would be the strongest reducing agent. All right, the value of the E show the potential of reduction reaction, which means high values, the reaction would occur very easily. Lower value means the reaction can occur but less potential. So if you have a competition of the two reactions, like fluorine receive electron, let's compare to copper ion receive electron, this one has lower potential than the first one. So if you have the competition of two reactions, this one will win. So fluorine will receive electron easier than copper ion. Where the E value has the negative sign, this means the reduction potential is not likely to occur, but rather the opposite. So let me show you, for example, the zinc ion receive electron producing has the reduction potential of negative 0.76, here, negative 0.76, which means reduction reaction is not likely to occur. But the opposite, if you reverse this reaction, you get zinc, lose electron, make zinc ion. This has the oxidation potential of 0.76 become a positive value. So the oxidation reaction is likely to occur than reduction reaction. So whenever you have a reduction half reaction in a positive E value, this means the reduction reaction occur very easily. Opposite, if you have the E reduction potential in a negative value, it means that this reaction is not likely to occur, but rather would be the opposite way or in the reverse reaction. Another thing that you need to make note on the value of E is like this one, the potential of the cell to receive or lose electron is an intrinsic property, which means that if you multiply any number or increase number of mole, the value of the potential does not change. So for example, one mole of copper ion receive two electrons and become copper has the potential as 0.34 volt. If you increase the amount of copper ion to be 2 moles, that makes receiving 4 electrons and produce 2 moles of copper. The potential of reduction potential remains the same, unchanged, 0.34 volts. So this is one thing that you need to note. It's different from what you learned earlier, that multiply any number to equation, you will multiply with the properties as well, but this one is not. Okay, from the table before, since the value of the potential cannot be measured for one half cell only, you have to get the connection of two half cells to see the cell potential. So the scientist must make up one cell as a standard, and that is the standard hydrogen electrode. In short, we call it a CHE, S-H-E, become a CHE. Alright, this standard hydrogen electrode consists of the reaction of proton produce hydrogen gas using a platinum inner material as the terminal. This is the reference electrode, and the electrode potential is said to be zero. Okay? And you see here, zoom into the previous table, you get this potential as zero. Any reaction that has higher potential of reduction reaction will go with a positive value. If a reaction has less potential to receive electron, will have a negative value, and the value of this positive or negative come from the experiment. Like this one, how to get the standard electrode potential. For example, in this particular slide, this show how do we get the potential of the zinc half cell as minus 0.76 before. So you construct a galvanic cell. You construct a galvanic cell, make the zinc half cell as anode or connect to the negative side of multimeter. Connect the Qi or standard hydrogen electrode as the cathode. Connect it to the positive side of multimeter and get the measurement and the multimeter showed the value of 0.76. Come to the calculation, E cell 0 equal to E of cathode minus E of anode. The E cell is the value of measurement, you get 0.76 down here, and cathode is the chi, and we set up the value for this particular electrode as 0. Therefore, we get reduction potential of zinc half cell as negative value of 0.76 volt. And when we did all the experiment, we get every value for the electrode, and then we can rank them as the table that you seen earlier. So you see, this is for the zinc half cell, has the reduction potential in a negative value. So for Daniell cell, we have zinc and copper. Okay, for Daniell cell, we have zinc and copper. The potential that show you here, the copper half cell has higher potential in terms of the reduction potential than the zinc half cell, which is why we connect the copper as cathode and connect zinc as anode, because this one would rather occur reduction and this one would rather occur oxidation. So let's see some example. Now try to do the calculation for E cell 0. The question asks you to calculate the standard cell voltage or E cell 0 of the following galvanic cell using the standard electrode potential. You have to consult the standard reduction potential table, okay? Get the value of aluminium half cell and the value of iron half cell. All right. We know the left side of the notation would be our anode. Okay, so anode reduction potential is minus 1.66 volt. You get this directly from the table. And then for the cathode, you get this value. Alright, put these two into the calculation, you get the answer straight away. Remember again, put the right sign, okay, so get the positive value. As I said from the introduction that we will see the relationship between the cell potential and spontaneous change. From chapter 5, we know that delta G of free energy change is the value that identifies the spontaneity of a reaction. The relationship between the free energy change and cell potential is shown on this slide. Delta G equal to negative NF E cell, or at the standard state, delta G 0 equal to negative NF E cell 0, where N is the number of mole of electrons transferred between electrodes, and F is a constant called Faraday constant and has the value of 96485 coulombs per mole of electron. As you see from this relationship, if the E cell is positive, that will make delta G as a negative. When the delta G is negative, the reaction would be spontaneous in the forward direction or from left to right. In the contrary, if E cell is negative, if E cell is negative, that will make delta G in a positive value. Positive delta G means non-spontaneous reaction. If E cell is zero, delta G is zero as well. So we say that the system is at equilibrium. And this occurs as we always learn. If the cell reaction is reverse, if the cell reaction is reverse, E cell and delta G would be the same value but in the opposite sign. So let's try to do the calculation. Answer this question. Does the following reaction occur spontaneously from left to right? Does the following reaction occur spontaneously from left to right? In this practice, we learn about electrochemistry, so we need to find the E cell value. Calculate E cell zero. Get the anode and cathode reduction potential. Okay, if the E cell is a positive value, it means your reaction is spontaneous. From the reaction, this is your oxidation reaction. Oxidation reaction, the oxidation number increase. So copper lose electron and become copper ion. Therefore, your silver ion change to silver would be your reduction reaction. Alright. What is the value of E anode and E cathode? Oxidation must occur at anode. Reduction must occur at cathode. So get the value of copper half cell as the anode from the table. You get this. Okay. Don't be confused. In the table, it will only show the reduction potential. Okay, it will only show the reduction potential. So take this directly from the table. But this one is your anode because of the reaction that you show here. This is the oxidation reaction must occur at the anode. Alright, so another one must be our cathode. And remember again, the number of mole that increase here for silver ion does not change the value of the reduction potential. Alright, so this is anode, this is cathode. We can calculate E cell now. But this one, cathode 0.80, anode 0.34. So we get E cell value as 0.46, a positive value. Positive value means this reaction is spontaneous. Easy, huh? Okay. Next, if you are asked to calculate the free energy change of this same reaction, what would it be? So we get the relationship between free energy change and E cell zero like this. So we just substitute the E cell value from the previous slide, substitute the constant value and number of mole of electron transfer between anode and cathode. So we will get something like this. Okay. The E cell 0.46 is here. This is a constant in Coulomb per mole of electron. And we have the transfer of two electrons. See, two electrons, two electrons. So delta G is negative sign, 8.88 times 10 raised to 5 joules. This unit come from Coulomb multiplied by volt, make joules. So it's the unit of energy. Negative Sign of delta G means this reaction is spontaneous. Same answer. Change into kilojoule, you will get this value. The last relationship that you need to consider is the relationship between equilibrium constant and E cell. In this chapter, we see this relationship, free energy change and E cell. And in chapter 5, we see this relationship, delta G, free energy change and equilibrium constant. Okay, logically, this equal to A equal to B and A equal to C, which means B equal to C as well. Okay, so this term will get this. Rearrange this equation, you get the relationship of E cell and equilibrium constant in a natural log or in a base 10 log like this. Substitute or the constant value, substitute the F, substitute the R, and substitute temperature at 25 degrees Celsius, you get this form. E cell 0 is equal to 0.0592 divided by N, base 10 log, equilibrium constant. So if you know E cell 0, you can calculate its equilibrium constant. Put everything together, you see the relationship in this pattern. Important variable, delta G, K, and E cell 0. This is related by this equation, delta G and E cell, this equation, delta G and K, this equation. And we learn also that delta G calculated from enthalpy change and entropy change. So if you know one variable, you can calculate the others. Let's see some example of calculation. If the Daniel cell, connect zinc and copper half cell has the standard cell voltage as 1.10 volt, calculate the equilibrium constant for this reaction. Very easy, you get the E cell 0 from the equation already. You know the N. N is number of electron transfer between zinc and copper ion. So it's used 2 electrons. So substitute everything in, you will get the K. K show a high value. K show high value, which means this reaction from left to right has the equilibrium on the right side or make a lot of product. And we talk about the standard condition. What about the non-standard condition? What about the E cell when we do not use the concentration of solution as 1 molar? So this is the Nernst equation that is used to calculate E cell at every condition rather than at standard condition only. So E cell, it would be equal to E cell 0 minus this term. Okay. When it's not at standard condition or it's not at equilibrium, we use log Q instead of log K. And Q, as before, is the reaction quotient. So you must know the reaction. You must know what is your product, what is your reactant, and make the ratio. Right? So, what is the cell potential of the following galvanic cell at 25 degrees Celsius? If the standard cell potential is 1.1 volt, this is not at standard condition because the concentration of solution are not 1 molar. Zinc ion solution has concentration of 1 times 10 minus 5 molar, where copper ion solution has concentration of 0.1 molar. So you're gonna need to use Nernst's equation. To start with this equation, what do we know? We know E0 already. We know N. We don't know Q. We need to calculate the Q first. Alright? From the cell notation, you get chemical reaction. Zinc react with copper ion. This is your reactant, right? Produce zinc ion and copper, your products. Okay. So what is Q? N is 2. Q is log concentration of product, which is zinc ion, divided by concentration of reactant, which is copper ion. This is 1 to 1 mole. So the power here are 1. Substitute the value of concentration from this notation down here, this down here. Right? So now we got everything. We can do the calculation for E0 now. Okay? Log Q make minus 4. So substitute this at this position. N is 2. This is E0 you got from the equation. So this is your E0. Right? So depends on the concentration of your solution. E0 that you measure from the multimeter might be different to the standard value. Another way of the calculation can be asking you to find what is the concentration of the solution in the galvanic cell instead. For example, this one. What is the concentration of zinc ion? If the galvanic cell below like this, show the E cell. This is the value of E cell, 1.535 volt. What is X? Okay, so you need Nernst's equation also. Alright. You know E cell. It's asked for X. X would be calculated from the Q. Okay. So what else do we know? We know that this is the anode. This is the anode. This is the cathode. Take the value of standard reduction potential from table. This is for anode and this is for cathode. So the E0 is calculated from these two values. The chemical reaction, zinc, react with silver. Zinc react with silver. Make silver, zinc ion and silver. Do the balance equation. Okay. E0 calculate from this anode and cathode. E0 E cathode minus E anode. You get 1.56 volt, N is 2, and log Q is 0.845. Okay, just rearrange this. This is the E0 minus E cell times N divided by 0.0592. You get the value of log Q as 0.845. then Q is, this is base 10 log, so Q is equal 10 raised to 0.0845 and the Q is 7. Q is the reaction quotient, so it calculates from concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. Now this time, number of mole is not 1 to 1 anymore, so this is 2. So remember to raise this power as 2 as well. Now you know concentration of silver ion. You don't know for zinc, so this is the calculation for zinc ion concentration. And here is your answer. Alright? Okay, I show you through again. When you are asked to calculate the concentration, you need to find this part of equation from Nernst's equation. Nernst's equation is L. This is given to you here. Alright, you need to find out what is E cell zero. So you need to know the potential of your anode and potential of your cathode. This is your anode because it's on the left side. This is your cathode because it's on the right side. You get the reduction potential of your anode and your cathode. You get the value of E cell zero. You know the N. So you can calculate the value of log Q, and then you get the Q value. Q is reaction quotient, which means concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. This is where most students forgot to check number of mole, right? Just rearrange this and you get the final answer, okay?
So we can apply this concept of Nernst equation to find out the pH of solution. If we can connect the carbonic cell between the hydrogen half cells, one that we know concentration already, or we use the standard hydrogen electrode that use hydrogen concentration or proton concentration as 1 molar, connect to another one that we don't know the concentration. And we learn from acid base chapter that concentration of proton is the pH of solution. See if we can connect carbonic cell like this and measuring the E cell value. This E cell value would be relate to the pH of the solution. So this is the principle behind the pH meter. But nowadays, the pH meter made from the glass electrode that use something else, not the Qi like this, because this involves the gas and is very awkward to use. This is the principle behind the pH meter and other ion selective electrode where you can have the half cell of other ions and then find out the difference in concentration and convert into the value that you want to know.
If you construct galvanic cell from the same type of electrodes and same type of solution, but use different concentration, the galvanic cell would be called a concentration cell. Concentration cell is a galvanic cell with two identical electrodes. Two identical electrodes, same terminal, same type of solution. The difference is that the solution in the half cell have different concentration. Like this one, you have on the left side has concentration of 0.025 molar, where another has concentration of 1.5 molar. The lower concentration will be the anode. The higher concentration will be the cathode. And the reaction would be from copper ion high concentration make copper ion low concentration. The electron transfer from anode to cathode anyway. The amount or the value of the cell potential that you will get from here depends on the difference between concentration of the two compartments. The higher the difference of concentration, the higher value of cell potential. This is the last of the galvanic cell topic. So I have some results to show you briefly here. We made the measurement of the concentration cell, E cell value, and show you here. This first one is the galvanic cell between 0.1 molar copper sulfate and 1 molar copper sulfate, compared to the second one, galvanic cell between 0.01 molar and 1 molar copper sulfate. So the difference of concentration here is lower than the difference of concentration in the second one. And the value that we've got are, for the first one, small value compared to the second one, a little bit higher value. You see that both of the concentration cells show a very low voltage, because this only depends on the difference of concentration. It only depends on the log Q part. So if the concentration are close together, the log is small value. If the concentration has the high differences, you get more volt out of it. So the conclusion is, if you have the higher difference of concentration, the second one, it will show your higher voltage. Note here that the measurement that we got from the result here are much lower than the one calculated from the Nernst equation. Now we move on to the last part of this chapter, the electrolytic cell. This is the electrochemical cell in which the electric current or electricity drives a non-spontaneous reaction to occur. So normally this reaction will never occur by itself unless we apply some electricity to it to make it happen. Compare galvanic cell that you've learned to the electrolytic cell. The different part would be this measurement from the multimeter, where this one you need power supply. The cathode and anode would be the opposite. Compare this reaction, spontaneous and non-spontaneous reaction. Spontaneous reaction, zinc would give electron to copper ion, because zinc has lower reduction potential than copper ion, so it will prefer to give away its electron. So the zinc ion will never receive electron, so it will be a non-spontaneous reaction unless you apply electricity to it. We connect these half cells to power supply. The electron from the power supply will go to the cathode side, and this zinc ion will receive electron. Zinc ion will receive electron. And the copper will lose electron to make a complete circuit. So this non-spontaneous reaction will occur. The power of the power supply here must be at least equal to the cell potential difference between copper and zinc half cell. So at least it has to be 1.1 volt to actually win over the cell potential. Alright, galvanic cell that we've learned, the anode. Has the negative sign. Cathode has a positive sign. In electrolytic cell, anode has a positive sign and cathode has the negative sign. The sign of electrode are the opposite from one another, but the sign cathode anode are the same, in which at anode, the reaction that occurs must be oxidation reaction. At cathode, the reaction that occur must be reduction reaction. Put it in comparison again. Galvanic cell, oxidation of A, losing electron. Reduction of B ion, receiving electron. And overall reaction is from A, losing electron, to B ion. The delta G would be negative value, and the E cell would be a positive value. In the electrolytic cell, is the opposite. Oxidation would be for B to lose electron, and A ion receive electron. Overall reaction would have a positive delta G value or the negative E cell value. So we have seen some electrolysis from experiment already. I have some more to show you on this slide. The first one, the electrolysis of lead to nitrate solution. Focus on the cathode here. You see very clear that the lead ion receive electron and form the lead on the wire. And then after we turn off the power supply, we can see very clear that on the cathode side, the lead deposit on this wire. What happened to the anode side on the nichrome wire, we have not yet identified. Where on the magnesium nitrate electrolysis, on the cathode side, rather than the magnesium ion receive electron and form the magnesium deposit on the wire, we see the bubbles of gas instead here. What happened to this electrolysis? The magnesium ion will not receive electron and form magnesium because the reduction potential is lower than water. So the competition between the reduction reaction occur and water molecule will receive electron instead, which is why you see the hydrogen gas bubble. And if you check the solution, you will see the if you check the solution with phenolphthalein, you will see the properties of base hydroxide here as well. Alright, so sometimes we may think that the ion of metal will form on the cathode side of electrolysis, but in the aqueous solution, water molecule can compete to receive electron with the metal ion instead, as you see in these two examples here. So it's all that I would give you lecture about in this chapter. Last thing that you need to do is to go to do this self-study about the application of galvanic cells and application of electrolytic cells. Mainly the application of galvanic cells is about the batteries, and the technology of batteries have been developed for a very long time, and at this moment in the present we're still searching for what we call a super battery. So there are a lot of information that you can learn about the technology of batteries. And for the electrolytic cell, you can find information about the electrolysis with we can have electrolysis of many things, and this is one thing to that used to produce some of the metal or some of the chemicals that use in a lot of industry, and also about the electro refining and electroplating. I'm not going to give you lecture about those, so I would need to ask you to do this self-study, nakha. And remember that nobody is forced you to do anything here, and you have to kind of set your own discipline to try to learn as much as you can. That's it for now, ค่ะ. Bye-bye, นะคะ.